from beating cancer and getting back to Pro Bowl level, one of the best players in the game.
First carry for Josh Adams. Takes this one across the 35 to the 36. A gain of about four.
Flat.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage and less traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
A three-yard gain and enough for the first down. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the others, you said, had a chance to get off the field. And didn't get it done.
On first down, Adams. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in. You're excited about hitting him in the first half, maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers. You're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
They give them 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. They'll run on first down. Adams. And a short gain down to about the 33.
We go.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally. Open up the crease so they can run through. That didn't happen on that play.
And he's going to take this one down to the 25. It'll go as a gain of 7 on the play, and it sets up a third and inches situation.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turning around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real injury is, when they see it, whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end in the direction they wanted to run the football. If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a game. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play. He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let them outside where they can really shred your defense.
Second down now. Adams. Open space inside the 10. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Josh Adams, 22 yards. And the Eagles drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Elliott Good with a PAT. And it's now a 7-0 game. Elliott now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. From Mahomes. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
Now Mahomes throwing on second down. And going deep. It got his man complete. takes this one down almost all the way to the 30.
Ace.
A gain of 38.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
Flush to his right. Eluding the pressure right. The Cowboys got it over the middle. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon as the Chiefs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10.
Here's the line. Here's the line. Third and two. Single.
Throwing now is Mahomes, escaping the pressure right. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and he made it a very manageable second and short.
They run it here. And he's brought down. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Odd. Five down. Stand up in. Kill.
Ace.
Going to take it into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Spencer Ware taking it in. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. Extra point right down the middle. And we are tied at 7. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take. And it's a unit last drive that did it all on the ground, Charles.
And they controlled it from the interior, big on big, right? Offensive lineman versus defensive lineman. But you know, in order to keep the football moving downfield, other people have to get involved as well. Your wide receivers, your tight ends, deep runners, anything that you have to do, get in front and keep the ball moving.
And now the defense may be looking out for a pass coming up. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. Play action fake. They'll look to throw. Gonna look deep for Jeffrey. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Ron Parker. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line.
The good old cover three defense, partner. When you start playing football as a safety, that's the first thing you're taught. Middle of the field, be as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone, and break on the football with a throw and pick it off, just as we saw there.
Flushed out right. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Fletcher Cox in there to get him for what will be a loss of 13 yards. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down.
Four down.
Mahomes to throw on second down. He's got his receiver. That's Sammy Watkins. A big game there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a third down. And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. And the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. Makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one. But it pays off. They convert. Mahomes now on first down.
I tell you, on fourth and one, when you're way back on your side of the field, I thought this might just be an attempt to draw him off and get the first down that way. But they were going for it the whole time, and they wind up getting it. Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and wins the hit.
And he'll get it down here to the 43. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the ball down. In that situation, it's almost a tendency breaker.
Throw left side, taken in by Hill. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 43 yards. And the Chiefs are in position. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Now to kick this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance 13. Out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar with a diet soda, where it bounces it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception.
He's got a man complete. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. Two minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Arrowhead after this. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. deep for Jeffrey. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by the safety here, Ron Parker. And a great return as they're finally able to take him down. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. That pass play wound up for negative yardage, so here's second and 11. Now here's Mahomes. Left side for Watkins, and he's got it. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A very solid gain of 27. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because they'll have...
Looking for Watkins, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Sidney Jones. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. He was looking for Watkins that time. Well, partner, league-wide, I think we're set up for a wild month of January. It seems like this season, more than others, we've had a number of teams that you maybe say, hey, they're the Super Bowl favorites. Kind of the Rams early, Rams, Chiefs, Patriots kept winning, the Saints, and now, heck, maybe even the Texans or the Bears could claim. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked up by Reggie Ragland. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. So that is three interceptions now in this first half, and you hate to ask the question, but let's be honest. We're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature.
There we go.
Green,
39.
He has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out.
This is taken in. It's complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 58 well. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. Mahomes now on first down. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker Jordan Hicks. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. Well, partner, like we always do this time of year with the holidays here and me happy for once, I want to say happy holidays to you, to your family, and to everybody out there in Madland.
I like how you said that. Before I do go on, though, happy holidays to you, your family, and everyone out there in Madland as well. Hope that they're safe and they're happy and successful holidays. As you said, happy for once. Usually you're kind of a Grinch this time of year. What's going on?
Yeah, well, my heart grew three sizes this winter.
I love it. I love it. Got to get you some new clothes to accommodate.
13.
But enjoy the holidays, everyone. Eat, be merry, enjoy your family time. They go play action here on first down.
I'm coming after you.
Caught right side tape. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here, as he'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one.
Here we go.
Eagles into the red zone for the first time. They've got a first and 10 at the 11. Here's the fake as they set up the throw. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off here by Anthony Hitchens. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Let's go. Interception, baby.
Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10. Is rare. Running right through it. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
Watch tight end. Tight end's right. Tight end's right.
Chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. So we've come upon halftime here in Arrowhead with the Chiefs on top. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? That's fielded in the end zone. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers. You do things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you're going to put some separation.
Adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Ace, it'll go as a gain of 10 and a Kansas City first down.
Now, this is an example of breaking down the defense because a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack. And guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to make a lot
of
tackles.
The tackle was made by Michael Bennett. Then he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just so quick. Terrific play, holding him to no gain.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
Black 58, rail! Mahomes
to the former Rams, Sammy Watkins for the Kansas City first. He's on the ground, they got the running back. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game.
Black 58, rail!
Tackle made that time by Brandon Graham.
I call that a success. A nice inside run. Sets up a
dirty. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Brandon Graham.
That's how we
in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. Going to need better protection here. Third and long following the sack for Mahomes and company. Looking to throw is Mahomes. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you.
Eagle pressure. Too much this time. Down he goes. Brandon Graham in there to drop him for his second sack now here tonight. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult.
It's
second down and 22 yards to go. Here's Mahomes to throw. He's going to rifle one deep outside. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The veteran Rasul Douglas able to break that one up.
Well, partner, I think the defensive fellas got the memo. And they decided to cover him on that play.
Yeah, he's already up over 100 yards in this game. They tried a deep shot there to get him.
Yeah, when you've had that much success, finally, someone said, let's try and put a stop to it and put people on him.
And now the Eagles going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Now Harrison Butker for the field goal try. From the left hash, this one 39. And Butker able to put this one through. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. So no problems at all on that one. And you know, there's virtually no win. This is a kicker's dream here tonight.
It absolutely is, isn't it? So to me, with no wind, it should be a passer's dream as well, yeah. Right? But in this case, the defense held out. They had to force the field goal.
So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of this game?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use. Just something to get you off to a quick start.
Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Adams. And he'll muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around 5. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are. On the road, he's one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made. And that just means you're one big score away from being right back.
The next question is, can this offense still sort of make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game.
Here we go.
Finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Now another timeout called for by the offense. And that's going to leave him with just one timeout remaining still in the third quarter. We'll see if that comes back to haunt him. We'll be back. And again, the run defense stopped this time. He maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage, but no more.
That's it, baby.
They tried to run it to the short side of the field. There just wasn't a whole lot of room to work with.
Yeah, it seems like things just kept getting strung out towards the sideline, and he kept looking for a spot to dive up into the gap. There just wasn't one, so that turned into nowhere to run, nowhere to hide.
And no gain.
Go.
Now throws. And Jeffrey's got it. Alshon Jeffrey. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Alshon Jeffrey, 53 yards. And the Eagles have cut it back within a score. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. That wasn't the one that was chasing.
Elliott Good on the extra point. And the lead's down to a field goal at 17-14. Elliott now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he nearly broke that for more, but as it is, they'll start this drive at about the 37-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
Hey, I'm with you. I like where you're thinking. I like where you're thinking because exactly right, trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down. And
he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. Second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprint stance. They just had to straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play.
Throw left side complete. It's Watkins. He'll get this one down.
Back 58 rail. Back 58 rail.
Just shy of the 20. A good pickup there, 26 yards. We're back now in KC. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point, just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle.
Here we go. Green.
Mahomes gonna throw.
His
throw is incomplete. The veteran Rasul Douglas able to break that one up.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past. The biggest teaching point, get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
Now look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Rasul Douglas picks it. And he'll take this back all the way up past the 45-yard line. A critical error there in a tight game of the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the football, and especially with a lead here in the fourth quarter.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter at what point, you got to be super careful.
Got to be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
53
is
the mic.
53
is the mic.
They'll run again with Adams, and that one blown up quickly. As he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. Big play coming
13,
up. Here's 13. Third and
10. I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they look to throw. Had another one. They are all over the football in this game. Nearly another pick. Now fourth down.
Trying to decipher what's going on out there, because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball. But he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football.
Several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown in. Frankly, that should have been another pick right there. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And he's got it. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A big pickup there, 20 yards as they convert on fourth. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
13, 13.
Yeah, a lot of people call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not going to be the deal.
They'll run on first down. Adams. And there is nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down in the backfield. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play. And he'll bring up a second and 11. Adams. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. The All-Pro Justin Houston in on the tackle.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. On play action, they'll throw. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. On the toss, this is Adams. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. It's second and goal, back to the 8-yard line now. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. They'll give it to him to the left, and he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard there, and that'll bring us to third and goal.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
So it's third and goal now, and this is where the Arrowhead crowd can make it very tough. They run it here with Adams. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Josh Adams, his second touchdown of the night. And the Eagles have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. They do tack on the extra point as well. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. now to kick this one away.
Yeah, nice catch. Nice catch. Touchdown. Nice catch, offense.
That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. And now here comes Kansas City. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice. You on a Friday, they go over this type of a situation.
Taken down.
Left.
Michael Gordon in there to take him down. The clock will roll.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. Five sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the
witching. Oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Rasul Douglas picks it, and they will set up shot.
I got so much beef, I get barely sleep. Paranoia got me losing on my Z's all day. Good love, mama praying on the knees all day. If you still frontin' when I up it, I'ma squeeze. Bad companies, bad for your company. Bad companies, bad for your company. In the ski mask, in case you come for me. Got in the ski mask, in case you come for me. When I say I got beef, they don't want no beef. When they say they got beef, they don't want to eat. If you said they want, they don't want no steam. She put it on it. Had a bachelor's degree, PhD while selling spellings. Fix the face and fix the weed. Now working on the self-esteem. Hit a block, yo, this flop. Where you at? Pin it. My new map location be the fly on the app.
So you know the jumping. They looking at me, he owe me some money.
I need that.
Hit him with the night the crumping. Why he playing games? They don't want no problems with me. My got good. You know I brought them. Might not hit a bad. Someone send them for opposition.
Say move wrong.
So I
dark shades, too much. Got to barely see them. Acting brand new like I don't see it when I do. Give me room, phony folks, play it close, you the most, don't they? Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad cow disease, now you in a ton of beef. Tucked underneath my new blue dunkaries. Flintstone, bust down, color Maricami. Fruity pepper, bezel, Wilma, Betty, Fred, and Barney. Bad, from out of town, I think she model Abercrombie. Wrist game, lucky charm, told my jeweler, leprechaun. I'ma come clean, I got beef. Paranoia got me rolling in my sleeves, okay. Dating cause I'm upping up the fees. Whole team got these on their tees all day. I got so much beef, I could barely sleep. Paranoia got me losing on my Z's all day. Good love, mama praying on the knees all day. If you still frightened when I up it, I'ma squeeze.
This is the NFL on EA Sports as we welcome you to MetLife Stadium here in East Rutherford, New Jersey. This is the scene just before we came on air. This New York crowd fired up by the arrival of their G-men as they burst from the locker room. They're ready to go as the Giants get set to match up with the Kansas City Chiefs. Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from MetLife Stadium. Screen
beautiful throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He can make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly.
27 to Sam.
Saquon Barkley slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of one, and they'll be facing a third and 12. Is again Barkley, and he'll take this one up close to the 25-yard line. Just a one-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down. So opening drive, three straight runs, unable to pick up the first.
I know the fans want to see first downs, but guess what? The coaches have reasons for what they're doing. Sometimes they've scripted it, and some of these runs, while they haven't been successful now, they may be successful later on.
They do go for it. It's Manning. Looking deep downfield. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. A surprising move to go for it, and predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off, and the Chiefs will have the football back in excellent field position. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
A first trip to the red zone for KC. They've got a first and goal from the 10-yard line. And they'll go ground game. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. A good run of 6 yards there. Gets him closer to the goal line with second down coming up. Second and goal from inside the five.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot on the ground and cut down.
And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Spencer Ware taking it in from a yard out. And the Chiefs are going to take a first quarter lead.
But they decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times that's a passing play.
And the kicker just has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief.
I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
The point after is good. And that makes the score 7-0. Butker now to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Giant offense now making their way back out onto the field. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it to 6 points. So they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do. The decision to go for it on fourth down, it caused every bit of it. But it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for him. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense, but they didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
On second down, here's Barkley. Stays on his feet. 8 yards here, so that gets him back within striking distance, and now it's third down.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
They've had touchdowns on both of their drives thus far. Zebra. Face a third and long. To his running back, complete.
Let's go.
Get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. Give him 8 on the play, and that's going to make it fourth down. Here we go on fourth down with Manning. Finds Beckham complete. And he is going to get the first down as he covers up after a pretty good shot there. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. First down carry for Barkley. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big body guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority.
And a minimum gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line.
They don't want it, fellas.
They'll get a couple yards on that one, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Sometimes your philosophies get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first two plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now facing a third and long at the outset of this drive.
Zebra, zebra.
Mike.
The throw on third down. Manning. Over the middle to Beckham. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. They stop him for only three that time, and that'll bring up fourth down. Now, the offense not going anywhere. They're staying out there. They've converted once already on this drive. Here they go again on fourth down. They'll try and throw for it here. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Orlando Scandrick. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10. At the 39-yard line.
We got three.
And they're going with a ground attack here. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a quarter, so. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49.
Hey, hey, hey. Black 58 rail. Black 58 rail.
Enough to move the chains.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because it feels like he's back on third down. First down. Sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are. Stay with who you know. And go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
An 11-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Chiefs first down.
Rail. Black 58 rail. Close, close, close. Check safety, check safety. Z, 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 Z. Ace, ace.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. He's going to let this one go deep. This is caught.
Hey, hey, hey.
And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 38 yards. And the Chiefs add on to their lead. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple football, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
This one fielded at the five. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns are probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think
he's into the clear. 30, 20, 10, and all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Saquon Barkley, 74 yards. And the Giants strike quickly here for 6 points. T up and good by Rosas. And that'll make our score 14-7. Rosas now to kick this one away. And And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And the Chiefs now getting set to go. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
They're getting up to about the 28-yard line. Olivier Vernon brings him down.
This case is dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right? And chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
Throwing now is Mahomes, eluding the pressure right. And it's complete to Kelce. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. First catch on that one for Kelce, and it's a first down.
And there was absolutely zero pressure on the quarterback on that play. Third down.
Left,
for a first down pickup.
And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. Because you can't get to his level if you don't take care of him first.
And he's going to get this past the 50 and into giant territory. Call it an 8-yard gain, much better shape than just a yard. And he gets it down to the 48, enough for the first. He needed a yard, that's what he got, and it's going to earn him a new set of downs.
Just about every coach we talk to says the crowd shouldn't affect us. That shouldn't be an issue. And then the next breath they talk about taking the crowd taking them out of the game by picking up first downs and keeping them at bay. I think we just saw an example of that there.
They've been important to you, especially early in the game like they have. Now he's forced out right. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
The best quarterbacks that ever played the game all wanted to blend in with their teammates and be one of the guys. But sometimes you got to take modesty and put it aside. You're the franchise quarterback, the face of the team, and the guy that leads them to victory. You have to get down and protect yourself and not take hits like that.
On the ground, the running back. Very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41.
But when you go from second to four to third and three, that just tells you who won that battle on the last play, huh?
Yeah, first round went to the offense, second round the defense. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. It's a gain of a yard, and it takes us to the two-minute warning. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to East Rutherford, but first this timeout. Feeling like they're not quite in field goal range yet, they're going to go for it on fourth. They'll go for it. It's Mahomes. He's going to find Hill here. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. A solid pickup of five and a very solid first down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration. It's Kelce on the ground. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective game nonetheless.
Now Mahomes. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result,
fall.
The football.
Mahomes looking to throw on third and two. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And he will have the first before he's
Black
brought down
rail.
On the chalk in the trail. That one good for seven as this long drive continues. And the chains move again. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. And now the Giants will stop play as they take a timeout defensively. As they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
You got three down.
On second down, here's Mahomes. Kelce, left side. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. The Chiefs on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This time it's third and three.
Hey, check, check. Three down, three down.
From the gun, it's Mahomes. Escaping the pressure right. He may try and run for this. The decision to tuck and run gets him three, but that's not enough. Now it's fourth. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. As the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. Again, the offense will stay out there. They've converted once on this drive. What can they do here on fourth down?
Left, 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 left.
To throw, it's Mahomes. This is caught by Hill for a Chiefs touchdown. Tyreek Hill with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now 21-7. Now to kick this one away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Giants offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
7 yards there on the first down screen play.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
That's it. Blue 80.
Manning the throw on second down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down.
Let's go, D. Big series right here.
Manning now on first down. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. The Pro Bowler Odell Beckham, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
Tight right.
To throw again. Manning. Going for the deep ball. And this is going to be intercepted. Snags it from the pick. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10.
Tight end right.
Final shot before the half from Mahomes.
We got three.
He's going to look deep down the field. And incomplete on the deep ball. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Ready for the start of the third quarter. The Chiefs have the lead and set to receive the football. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Yardage back at the 35. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, partner, I guess sometimes it's just a matter of philosophy. Some say run until they absolutely stop you, and others say, well, we need to think about this down game. Fool them a little bit. I guess they should have tried to fool them on that play.
Complete the tight end, Kelsey. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Give him 15 yards on that one. Kansas City has a first down.
Check, 93's the mic, 93's the mic.
Left, 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 left. Z, 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 Z.
Mahomes now on first down. Receiver complete.
Yeah,
and he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 23 yards on the play. So the drive takes him into Giants territory now. First and 10 as they've got it to the 28-yard line. Game here with a tailback down to the 25. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
I was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it. So his defenders, they were rallying to the football.
And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
They're in a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves, start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now.
Kill, kill, kill. Watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out.
And they'll go with a down attack here. 2 yards on the pick up there. It's fourth down. Now Harrison Butker for the field goal try. This a 40-yard attempt from the left end. And the kick by Butker is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So chalk that down as an 8-play drive capped with a field goal.
Yeah, as a friend of mine used to say, they were moving and grooving for a while, but they couldn't keep the momentum going enough to get a touchdown out of it.
This is taken at his 4. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Here's the Giants offense now getting set to start the third quarter. Manning and the Giants come up now first and 10
zebra, zebra.
At their own 26.
Even,
trying to shake off the interception. He'll lose a throw. And it's knocked away and incomplete. It was Orlando Scandrick, the one that time, to knock it away. Hey, we got a second here. Let's go back to week 15 following the win over Green Bay for Chicago. Happiness rained down on the field. The Bears claiming the NFC North title, but one Bear took his celebration to an extreme. I know you saw this.
Yes, I certainly did. Zebra. Charles Leno Jr., left tackle for the Chicago Bears, got down on the knee and proposed to his girlfriend Jennifer. So not only celebrating an NFC North title, but now his proposal accepted by Jennifer, who will now be Mrs. Jennifer Leno Jr.? No, no Junior.
No Junior. By the way, smart move, because she's not going to say no in front of 60,000 people.
Zebra, zebra, zebra. Before. Not pretty, but not in this case.
On third down, Manning. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's 4.
And we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on four.
Zebra, zebra, zebra.
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. He finds Coleman. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Facing a fourth down, they come away with 18 yards and a first down conversion. A pair of first downs gives them a first and 10 up at the 44. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Zebra, zebra, zebra.
From our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They got to feel pretty good about that one.
It's a 5-yard game, but they'll still be a yard short here with third down now looming.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Manning, he dumps it off to Barkley. And he will go out right near the 35-yard line. They give him 12 yards and a first down.
Zebra, zebra, zebra.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers and tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Here's second and 10 now from the 35.
Single receiver. Hey, you're on an island over there. Single receiver.
I got you, 88. I got you.
Manning will try again on second down.
Come on,
down.
Come on,
that is caught at the 7. And he will take it all in for a giant touchdown. Sterling Shepard, 35 yards. And the Giants are able to cut into this lead. So now Eli and the Giants will line up and go for two.
Don't worry about that.
Single, single. I got a single in the slot. Single in the slot.
Mike, 15.
Now Manning again. Flushed out right. And he's got it here for the 2 points, but there is a marker down. So we'll have to see what that's about. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Rosas now to kick this one away. This is taken at the 3. Now a hit and a loose football. Take it right down Broadway. And he will score. Touchdown, Giants. Giants have got it back to a 1-score game. Here we go now as we get set for a big 2-point conversion.
Tight end on the ringo. Tight end on the ringo.
What's that? Blue 88. Blue 88. Zebra, zebra, zebra.
Working from the gun, Manning. Flush to his right. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a 2-point conversion, there's not any extra field, so it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
And now here comes Kansas City. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
No, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three or something. Trying to ice a game. That's sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as we get this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there.
Let's get three, right? Not one that I've ever met.
That's a good way to start the drive, 17 yards and a first down.
Well, how about this aggressive approach? Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about
something? Z.
Atlanta have the lead against New England, and they ended up picking it up.
I didn't say it, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, anybody watching Atlanta, our apologies. Lead it to Hill. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off, okay? So they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync. Great communication. As he ran it across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. And they're making a nice play, even though it was complete. Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
He's been big. Two touchdowns earlier. Now he's got a first down here. Mahomes now 13 of 15 passing. That's good for 87%. It's first and 10. Here's Mahomes. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. Throw on second down. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, no, he lost the football. And this is going to get out of bounds, so they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, and they'll hold on to the football as well.
I don't know about you, but I can hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. The ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession. No turnover. I know his coaches are screaming. Just hang on to the ball, man.
Give him seven on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs. That is an absolute backbreaker. That was a designed passing play. Wasn't a draw. You think you got him stopped. Good coverage downfield. And he's able to pick up with his legs defensively. That kicks it in the psyche and hurts a little bit, doesn't it?
It certainly does. And here's the thing. Anytime you give up a first down, it hurts you psychologically. But it hurts more when they get it this way. Because you've covered everything. He didn't have any place to throw the football. He takes off running and picks it up anyway. And now you have to stay on the field for an extra set of downs.
And really could have used that stop trailing here in the fourth.
Five down. Stand up in.
Now they're playing with Mahomes. And look at this. They get the turnover. They get it. It's intercepted. Picked off inside the five. Past the 10 to the 11-yard line. And that's where the return stops. How about the big boys snagging one? You don't see that every week.
No, you don't, but a lot of them are just reliving their old dreams, going back to when they were in youth football and in high school. They didn't always play defensive line. Some of them actually handled the football. You can see the flashback.
That's Saquon Barkley. And some room for him there as he'll take this up to about the 15. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this.
Regular.
SOS, SOS.
That's it. Blue 88.
Mike, 53. Check 53.
And go 56. 27 to Sam. 27 to Sam.
Manning to throw on second down. It's caught. Beckham. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. He got 29 yards that time. Manning now a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. First and 10.
Hey, tight, tight.
Back to throw.
Check.
And incomplete. This defense has watched their lead dwindle away. This is where they really need to bow up. They executed well there.
And it's often hard after you've played really well early and then you kind of relax a little bit to step on the gas again. They just did it on the last play.
Zebra, zebra.
Looks like they want to finish this one off.
Back to throw. To Barkley on the check down. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Let's go.
Regular.
All day,
baby.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take it down to about the 35 here. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. Now the Giants will use the second of their 3 timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Yardage back at the 38. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. The Giants on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This will be 3rd and 5.
Regular.
They'll look to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his left. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
Let's get it.
Let's go. Zebra.
3 down.
Zebra.
He's back to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. He was looking for Odell Beckham that time. And now it's 2nd down. These are the spots, this stage of the game, where it pays to have speed on the perimeter, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and in the second quarter, he may very well run by him, but in this situation, I know as a defender, I'm loosening up a couple of extra steps that allowed him to run with him stride for stride.
Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up 1st and goal. That's what they need right now. Get the 1st down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
Zebra. Hey, gun.
Back to throw, Manning, and this is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
A score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get over-eager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
The throw is Manning. And this is caught. And it's a 3-point game. So they make the decision. They want a 3-point lead versus a 2-point lead, and they got it.
Yeah, at this stage of the game, it seems like the exact right thing to do. Put a little pressure on your defense, but the biggest thing now is you're making the other team chase you.
Let's field it at the 2. He's got a convoy, and he might be gone. Past the 20, 10, and he's going to take it to the end zone. What a return, and they've taken the lead.
How many people watching this one right here gave up, because that score, they might want to try and rush back into this stadium.
Yeah. Well, it looks like there's going to be the game deciding score, although a little bit of time left, so you can't count your chickens before they're hatched.
Well, they better come back in here and watch this one, because you and I, we're not going anywhere. We want to see this one play out.
So now the other return teams out there, as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Giant offense now as they get ready to take over here. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. This is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, you gotta get out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat and mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring, and how much pressure can the offense handle?
We're going to find out. Desperation throw deep downfield. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. And that is going to seal this victory as time runs out. Well, we were on hand for a fun and entertaining game here, coming down really to that last play. Great job defensively to get the pick and seal it.
And we know that every play during a game matters. You're never sure which one's going to be one of the key ones. But at the end of the game, when you analyze it, three, four, five plays are going to be the ones you focus on. And that last play was one of them. The last shot, had to take it. And they came up with the interception and sealed their victory.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. With that, we sign off from MetLife Stadium.
Addicted to balling, I have to get my cash. The money is calling, got bands, got bands, got bands. I'm addicted to balling. I'm addicted to balling. I have to get my ends. I pull up in my Benz, flexing, counting my bands. Started getting money, I see how it feels to be rich. Trying to
started loving me too quick. Went to Oakland with a few. Took them all your break. Yeah. Imagine what I paid for the Rollie. Still from the police.
We're at the home of the Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up with the Kansas City Chiefs. Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. This is taken at his four. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. They go play action here on first down. It's complete to Gordon to go. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A gain of 32 that time. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Try to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. As he stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
Yes, sir. I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just
here we go.
That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
53 is the mic.
Go.
Inside the 25. First connection there of the afternoon for those two, and it's good for a first down.
Here we go.
Check. 53's Mike. Check. 53's Mike. Let's go, T.
Hey, silent one.
Tell me hello, okay.
Under.
Play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11.
He wasn't ready.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11.
Thick!
Action, no throw. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Here we go.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
He's going to let one fly for Tate. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. Golden Tate. Taken the early lead. On for the extra point, Jake Elliott good with a PAT, and it's now a 7-0 game. Elliott now to kick this one away. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now Mahomes. He's got his receiver. That's Sammy Watkins. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Defense gives up a touchdown in the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. Now he'll escape to his right. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. Brandon Graham in there to bury him for a loss of 11. Now they're in some hot water now after that sack. Second and 21. Here's Mahomes to throw. He's got Watkins. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A good pickup there of 22. So again from the 39, this time from the other side of the field. Here's first and 10. On first and 10, here's Mahomes. And he'll win it over the middle. And he gets it down to the 32. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest to defend? Any of them, especially if it's a good receiver, that makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line.
Get there.
Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the line. Running game working. Will stick with him for a stand. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That one good for 12 yards and a Kansas City first.
That's another nice run, and I have to tell you, some of the coaches that I played for, their philosophies were always different when they see a guy running the ball well. Some of them wanted to immediately go to play action and throw it now because it's wide open. Well, other coaches said, you know something? Until they stop him, that big boy's going to keep getting the football. And that might be the direction that they're going to go right now.
A first trip to the red zone for KC. They come up first and 10 at the 16.
Everyone's got four.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. He will push his way down to about the 14.
Oh, yeah.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
He may be a bit undersized 36. Compared to the modern-day NFL defensive tackle. He lacks in size. He makes up for his ability to make tackles in the run game as well.
And he'll get about three just outside the 10, stopped at the 11.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackle, because we ask them to just eat up blocks, allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
One back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
What an advantage having an elite guy in the middle of the defensive line, because not only does he take up the space and let the linebackers run free, but also make plays himself.
He'll get it up the middle, and he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal?
47 Mike.
Mahomes now to throw. And that is incomplete. Nigel Bradham, the linebacker, right there on the coverage.
Now let's go ahead and try and get into the body and the mind of the linebackers. Yeah, I know they're bigger and stronger than I ever was, but in this situation, they understood what was going on as much as the offensive guys. Because the offensive guys are always taught, find the first down sticks and make the play. On defense, what do you want to do? Guard the first down line. Make sure they don't get there and tackle them in front. They're able to drop in their zone coverage, figure out where the first down line was, and end up making the play, swatting it away so they couldn't get the completion.
And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Eagles coming out as they get ready. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainy yet. Did you trade sixes for threes?
Go, go, go.
Things are gonna work out in your favor.
Play fake here on first down. Incomplete to Zach Ertz. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. Clock running, under four to play now as they come up on first and 10.
Hey, check 24, check 24.
Wide 80. Water, water.
53 is the mic.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Room to run past midfield. The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And he'll take this down to the 40-yard line. That one goes for 24 yards.
Under.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run. He's able to do that on that play and picks up the first down with a nice throw.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
You got him.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Here we go, here we go. Great, great. Here we go, here we go, here we go.
Check. Here's a fake as they set up the throw. Jeffrey heels it in over the middle. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. He got 29 yards that time. The Eagles into the red zone for the first time. They've got a first and goal from the 10-yard line.
Even, even. Four down.
Even,
even. Down. Hey,
sound
one.
Undercrush.
Here's Foles. Looking for Jeffrey, and it's intercepted. Positioning, and it's picked off. And to the 12. That's where it stops. The return is halted at the 12-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? But instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Chris Conley, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much. Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Fletcher Cox coming up the middle, gets him there for a loss of about 9. After the sack, they'll come up now 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Well, shame on them, Coach Davis. They went against your advice. They threw the football, and now they're backed up to punt this away.
They're actually fortunate. They went against my advice, but they didn't turn it over, right? No takeaway for the defense. They'll punt it now. They probably could have gained a few yards if they ran it, though, and helped out with field position.
Here's Dustin Colquitt now. And no room for air here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. Now Sproles. A big kick, 50 yards that time, with a return of 4. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. The Eagles offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in this spot. We think we've got 3 on the board for sure. It'll come over with nothing.
Will they make up for it? And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As they'll stop it with just over a minute to go halftime. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. On the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's going to let one fly for. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Rod Parker. And a big turnover there as as his guys will get the football back.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Throw, throw, throw!
Watch tight end. Tight end's right. Tight end's right.
Here we go now. Blue 45. Blue 45.
So after the INT, here's Mahomes. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist.
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble. Mahomes can't get away,
again.
And down he goes.
Again.
Brandon Graham in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Third and long, it's Mahomes. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back at the 2. And the Eagles are going to go ahead and take another timeout as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number 1. So a short drop, but he's able to get it out, and this is a good kick. Returnable here from the 38. A very good return that time. 18 yards. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The fourth down
13,
run 13. Successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. And they're back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Under pressure, and he will
here we go.
Sacked back at the 46. Now a signal and a timeout call. As it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play.
Let's go.
After the sack, it's 2nd and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here.
Hey, turn it up.
Back to throw here. Gonna look deep for Jeffrey. This is taken in by Jeffrey. He's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. Alshon Jeffrey in the final seconds of the first half. And the Eagles are able to strike quickly for 6. Elliott good on the extra point. And that pushes the lead up to 11. Elliott now to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. Fielded about a yard deep. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make things more important than it is. Right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. But this is a I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start the game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Now, a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 ball. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with it.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. He can run for it, and he will. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. Pretty solid gain of 7 yards that time as he scrambled, but now they face a fourth down. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They do go for it. It's Mahomes. Nigel Bradham, the linebacker, right there on the coverage. But down 2 scores, I guess they felt like they needed to go for it. They must have thought they had a play to dial up that they could get it. Well, didn't work out.
They must have thought, as you pointed out, they had a play. And they were probably looking at the 13, number of possessions 13. That they thought were left in the game. And down 2 scores, it must have felt like they couldn't risk not taking a shot here and giving up that chance.
He's going to let one fly. This is caught inside the 5. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. They give him a gain of 37.
Here we go, here we go.
This one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Three down. Hey, fellas, we got 3. Let's go.
Mike, 53. Mike.
Go with 5-3. Go with 5-3.
I got you, son. Slam.
Yes. They'll give it to him up the top. And he's in. Touchdown. Josh Adams taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Eagles had 6 to their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit. Get some breathing room.
I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game. You know, the second half, no matter what, with his first 5 minutes, first 3, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
Fielded about a yard deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense takes care of the defense. Defense takes care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short game.
And that's going to be incomplete. The veteran Rasul Douglas able to break that one up.
You know they wanted, you know they expected, they needed him to be sharp coming out after the half. Unfortunately, he's missed his first 3 throws. I wonder if he got out late and missed his warm-up time.
The whole team did come out a little bit later than usual. I don't know, maybe there's something to that.
Must have been a heck of a halftime speech.
Maybe just trying to rally the troops back from this deficit.
He's checking.
From the gun on third down, Mahomes on target over the middle of Hill. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. An 11-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Chiefs first down.
Black 58 rail!
Did you see that route the way that I did? I thought he was trying to get deep.
Yeah, that wasn't the first option.
No, not the first option. The deep guy, and came underneath on the drag. Completed it very well.
And to throw is Mahomes. Throwing the slant pattern here, complete.
Yeah,
give him nine there. Black 58 rail.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays. I'm glad I didn't make it in that league. Difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Everyone's got four. Four down.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10.
Black 58 rail. Black 58 rail. Z, Z, Z. Z, Z, Z. Here we go now.
Connection there, it's incomplete. Not that time for Watkins, and that'll bring up second down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback.
Now here's Mahomes. Looking again for Watkins, and this time that's complete. That one goes for 36 yards. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game.
Tight end right, tight end right. Left, 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 left.
Five down. Stand up big.
Now it's Mahomes again. And he checks this one down to Williams. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the four-yard line. That'll wind up going for a loss of four. And it'll be second and goal.
Even, four down.
And again, it's Mahomes being chased out left. Pass incomplete. Nigel Bradham, the linebacker, right there on the coverage.
What a job by this defense all game long. They've come together and really said, no one's crossing our goal line, and they're definitely not going to start right now.
You can just see the dejection. Feel like nothing is working offensively. They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. Mahomes to throw once more. This is caught by Hill for a Chiefs touchdown.
Baby, get him, boy.
Tyreek Hill from 4 yards out. And the Chiefs are able to cut into this lead. The extra point up and good. And that will shave one more off this lead. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
So they touched it before it went 10, and that's obviously not going to help their comeback bid here in the fourth.
No, not at all. And they're trying to get something going after one there. But you've got to give yourself a chance. Let it go 10 before you touch it.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10. Here's Adams. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes. was folded like a lawn chair.
Okay, Bones,
they'll wind up losing 3 yards here.
And
it'll bring up a 2nd and 13. So now they have to contend with 2nd and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. On play action. Justin Houston in there to pick up his 2nd sack now of the afternoon.
It's a team game, but sometimes individuals do stand out, don't they? How about that for a twofer? Tackle for a loss on the running play on the previous down, and then comes right back and gets a sack.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after 1st and 2nd down with backwards. It's 3rd and very long. And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked off here by Anthony Hitchens. But he's able to bring it up 5 yards shy of midfield to the 45-yard line.
Well, it's 3rd and long, and you've got a few different ways to play it offensively. But this is not the type of offense that's going to wave the white flag. They're going to keep chucking it. And this time, it results in an interception.
Looking left side for Watkins, and he's got him. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside Black the 58 45.
Black 58 rail.
Pick up there, a 22. Right after the turn, they're coming out
and that means a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Throwing on 2nd down. That one complete to Hill. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face 3rd down.
When you see running defense and you know you've got to drag down as a primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
It'll wind up being a loss of 2. And that'll bring up 4th down. And now before this 4th and 2 play comes to fruition, they're going to think about it and call a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the 4th quarter. And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down.
Left.
So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out.
58, right over there.
Now Mahomes got to have this one. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Rasul Douglas picks it. Watkins, the intended receiver.
Partner, we always talk about possessions being at a premium in these games, and now in this situation, throwing an interception here when you have to claw your way back in, that one's going to hurt, and in a big way.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Yardage back to the 29. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down.
Okay,
got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Foles. And intercepted. Maybe the total point they need. Picked up by Reggie Ragland. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. That is the play they needed in a 2-score game here in the 4th quarter.
No doubt about it. They did what they had to do to give themselves a chance to get back into the game.
And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. That one good for 12 yards in a Kansas City first.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity, usually gets better as the game goes on. But I just don't know.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Brandon Graham.
Black 58 rail. Black 58 rail.
His 3rd sack of the afternoon. Shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line.
Check,
given 7
check
on the play, and just like that, it's 3rd down.
Black 58 rail! Black 58 rail!
Watch
Throwing is Mahomes on third. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete.
We know all the receivers go through those tiptoe drills, right, trying to get their feet down in bounds. But a lot of the times what we don't talk about is when they're up in the air and they catch the ball. You ever notice how they're reaching back with their feet, not just straight down, but back, because they're trying to create enough distance to make sure their feet are in bounds. They weren't able to get it done on that one, though.
Slow. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And now this is going to be close. The defense says they stopped him, and they did. Andy Reid went for it, but it won't pan out. And the Eagles defense able to hold.
Check 31, check
31. Easy, easy. Set, 180.
And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 14-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Defensively, no doubt they need a quick stop. Offensively here, maybe you put it in the air on second down, or do you go ahead and keep it on the ground, keep that clock moving?
A lot of people would ask that question, because sometimes throwing the ball might actually be the path of least resistance. But in this case, it's a matter of trust. How much do you trust your quarterback? Because you throw the ball and it goes awry, you really don't look smart as a coach.
Yeah, and then you stop that clock. The Eagles on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This will be third and 6.
Four down. Check.
49.
He's crashing.
Yes.
A play action fake. They'll look to throw. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this.
Check. Lucky.
Adams. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining.
Here we go.
Running situation on the doorstep as they come up second and 10.
Right in.
It looks like he'll throw here. And eventually taken down here. Great coverage downfield. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. As he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down.
He's coming. Double up. Mike, 53.
Hey, Silver.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's got a man wide open, complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And that one good for 16 yards and a first. A pair of first downs gives him a first and 10 up at the 44.
You go tight right there.
This run on first down. Adams. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. An ideal down and distance to try to finish this thing off. Second and inches.
53.
On second down, Adams. And he'll go down at the 28. It's a gain of 6, and that ought to just about do it. Starting to look like this drive, it may be the final nail in the coffin.
Well, this is why you work out so hard, right? This is why you spend all that time in the offseason. This is why you have those OTAs in minicamp. These situations, these scenarios, to run someone into the ground and secure a victory.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Here we go.
I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. It doesn't matter whether you've watched high school or college or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy trying to get the running play in, and it can backfire on them.
And he stopped immediately there. Allen Bailey in on the stop.
Right there.
Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about the miracle of Meadowlands? All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time.
And this will be caught. Taking the knee. Some late gamesmanship here as they throw for a late touchdown.
Is it okay if I break one of our rules, partner, which is to never call a game over until it's over? Because it certainly feels like it's over.
Yeah, that was spirit-crushing, wasn't it? And now you just kind of felt the air go out of the balloon.
Yeah, they were fighting so hard to stay in there, and they knew they had to stop them on that drive. But when they were unable to, I think you're exactly right. You could see them sag on their sideline, and I think this one might just be over.
And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Eagles are winners here as we say so long from Philadelphia.
Come here.